Hey everyone, today we're going to learn how to add variables to our xAPI statements in our articulated storyline. So if you wanted to provide additional context or context that changes based on what the user has actually selected or inputted, we're going to go ahead and work with that today. Jeff Batt with Learning Dojo, and if you haven't checked out my website already, go ahead and check out my website at learningdojo.ninja. You can check out all previous blog posts with tips and tricks on xAPI and Articulate Storyline, as well as other tools. And also, you can check out templates on Articulate Storyline 360, xAPI video templates, and you can check out full courses if you're new to Articulate Storyline or new to xAPI. You can check out full courses, everything from A to Z with hands-on projects on Articulate Storyline 360, Adobe Captivate, xAPI Fundamentals, Articulate Rise, Custom Squirm, and HTML5 Video. Today we're going to learn how to take some content that a user has adjusted or inputted and use that when we send over xAPI statements. And we're going to do this with CMI5 as well as xAPI. So if you have a learning management system that allows you to send over or to track via CMI5 or xAPI, then you can use this process here. Or if you're sending over to an external learning record store, you can do this as well. If you're not familiar with those terms that I just said, you may want to check out my full course on xAPI, or you can check out my blog, and my blog has a couple different kind of high-level overviews of xAPI as well. All right, so let's go ahead, and I'm just going to build kind of a very simple interaction instead of Articulate Storyline. A lot of people ask me sometimes is like, why do you keep it so simple? It's just, I want you to focus on the functionality rather than, okay, how did you create that image? How did you do that layout? And so that's the reason why I keep it as simple as possible with the layout. So you're just focused on the actual functionality here. So I'm going to go ahead and start a new project, and we're going to create a sample project with one page, and it's going to have a slider. And it's also going to have a text input. And then once we send over our statement, when they click on the next button or when they click on a submit button, it's gonna add the contents that we did with the slider and the text entry into that statement. So I'm gonna go ahead and just adjust the size of this. I always like to at least get it to 1,000. So 16x9, first of all, and then up that to 1,000 width and click OK. That way it has the wider screen there. I'm gonna save this, and I'm gonna save this on my desktop and just call it sample here. And then I'm gonna insert a couple different things. Now we need to have variables for our slider, and we need to have a variable for our text entry. If you just insert a text entry, if I come into insert and then go into input right here, and then do a text entry right there, it is automatically going to create a variable called text entry. I want to rename that. So I'm going to just go into my variables here, and instead of just text entry, I'm going to say user's name. We don't know what the default value is. It's going to be blank by default, but I'm going to click OK, and then I'm going to click OK there. So now look here where it will set the user's name equal to the typed value. So whenever the user types something in here or their name in here, then it will set that variable to that value. So that's step number one, pretty easy. You also probably want to have some text. So I'm going to insert a text box that says a prompt like enter name. And then I'm going to make that a little bit smaller, and let's bold that as well. So a little bit nicer there. There we go. I think that's great. Enter name. That's the first variable that we're going to capture. The second variable is a slider. So I'm going to go down to slider here under the insert tab. And then in the slider, you can choose what type of slider that you want. I'm going to just select anywhere this slider, and then you can adjust visually, just stretch it out here as you want. And then if you go into the slider tools, there's a couple different things that you can do. Notice that this also creates a variable automatically called variable one. I want to have this a little bit more specific, so I'm going to do the same thing that I did with the input and change slider one to actually something else. We're going to change this to, let's call it rating, like the user is going to rate the course or something. and I'm going to select OK. This is in the slider where you adjust some of the different things, like where the start is going to be 0 and the end is going to be 10, which basically means that, hey, on a scale of 1 to 10, how would you rate this course, basically? And then step means how, you know, when they start to slide, does it increase by 2 or does it decrease decrease by 2 or does it increase by 1? In this case, it probably makes sense to be 1. And then we probably want to have some prompts of this being 0 and this being 10 here. But then the initial one is like, where do you want that little dial to actually be? I'm going to say the initial is going to be at 5. It's going to be smack dab in the middle, and they can adjust it to 0 or they can adjust it to 1. Let's insert some text, and just so the user knows that this is going to be 0 on the left-hand side here. And then we're going to insert or just copy paste that, and this is going to be 10 on the right-hand side here. So on a scale of 1 to 10, how would you rate this course? And that's probably where I'd want to put some text on a scale of 1 to 10. How would you rate this course? But for now, let's just keep it like this. So the user is going to slide this forward or backwards, and it's going to rate that. Now, we have those two different variables. We have the slider or the rating, and then we have the username. We're capturing the data that the user is going to adjust. But now, in order for us to see it, because it's just local at this point, it's just inside the course, in order for us to see it, we need to capture it inside of the learning record store in xAPI. This is where I come in and add an xAPI statement. So I'm going to go ahead and insert a button. And you have to think about, when do you want to actually send over the xAPI statement? Do you want to do it when they click on the next button? Do you want to click it or create a submit button and do it when they click on the submit button? Do you want to do it when they actually slide it? And if you do that, though, it's going to do it every time it changes, basically. Every time that variable changes, it's going to submit a statement. So I probably don't want to send it that much. I'm going to go ahead and just submit or create a box that says submit, and that will submit the feedback, basically. What we need to do is create a trigger on that submit button. So I'm going to add a trigger, and what it's going to do is it's going to send over an xAPI statement. From here, I'm going to select the drop-down box, and I'm going to go ahead and go down to send xAPI statements. Now, this will allow me to choose what type of verb I want to do here. And you can see abandoned, answered, asked, attempted, attended, commented, completed, all those different things. But we're going to try to find one that's actually similar to rating. And answered might be close enough, or asked. So they didn't really ask. Attempted, attended, interacted might be one. There is a way to add additional verbs, but for now, these are kind of the basic ones. I'm going to go ahead and just say answered. And then what did they answer is the next thing. And then we're going to say readings question with. Now, what did they answer with? I don't know. I mean, that's where the variables come into play. I don't actually even need to capture their name, because when you're doing this with CMI5, it will capture the name from the learning management system automatically. But I did capture it, so we could just place it inside of the informational here, or informational content here. I need to be able to insert the variable. To do that, you have to click on the plus xAPI option here, because this will expand out the additional information. So right now we have verb, and then we have the object. Again, the actor, there's three parts to an xAPI statement: the actor, the verb, and the object. The actor is the person, and that is going to be captured by the LMS, so we don't have to worry about that. Jeff Bat answered, what did I answer? Well, it didn't actually, it kind of got rid of what I had typed in there, and so I probably want to type something else in here. So definition, we probably want to be able to type, well, let me actually go back here, because it creates an ID for me automatically. So I'm going to say custom, and then custom text, and then I'm going to type in answered ratings question with, and then select OK. Well, the reason why I do that is because if you don't do that initially, when you click on the plus xAPI, it doesn't generate this ID for you, and it doesn't generate that text for you automatically. It's weird. You can still generate that ID, but it automatically does it for me there. So just one less worry there. All right, so ratings question with. Now notice in here, this is JSON content. So I can insert additional content within these quotes. You have to keep it within the quotes here. But up on the top, we have variables, and this is where I can choose that rating variable. And so right now it'll say Jeff Batt answered the ratings question with, and then it will just say the number. I probably want to say with the score of, and then the number right there. Now I'm going to go ahead and just say, I'm going to insert the other variable, which is username. So I added a dash username just to show that this is the person that actually answered it. I don't necessarily need to do it in this case, but that's how you can add on and you can have more than just one additional content here. There are other options under xAPI. You can go under verb and change the verb. You can go into object and adjust the object or click on reset and it will reset it back to the settings there. But for now, I think that's good enough. So I'm gonna click okay. And then I'm gonna click okay here. Now that's gonna happen when the user clicks on that submit button. And that's really all that I need to do. So I'm gonna go ahead. Actually, let's, instead of enter name, what I want to do is enter, let's do enter, not dates, because it'll capture the date automatically. Enter location. There we go. So I'm going to change that variable to, instead of username, let's go ahead and just change this to location. I was struggling with the name because we already are capturing the actor here, but I'm going to go ahead and select okay. And then I'm going to go back to that custom statement one here, which you can just select the text and then at location. And then we're going to insert location right there. All right. So now we have both variables and it makes sense there. Let's go ahead and publish this out. And I'm going to publish this to CMI5 because it's going to publish and capture the data. If your learning management system doesn't accept CMI5, you could publish to, some of them do xAPI and just xAPI. If they don't, then you may have to do an external learning record store right here. But I'm gonna click okay, and actually make sure this is on my desktop first of all. So I'm gonna select desktop, select folder, publish right here. It will publish out to my desktop. And I'm gonna go to Squirm Cloud. cloud.squirm.com is the testing LMS that I usually use. And I'm going to, as that's publishing out, let's make sure that we zip this up. So going back into here, I'm going to upload this to CMI5 or the CMI5 package. And I'm going to upload this to Squirm Cloud. So click on import course. Now we can go ahead and launch the course. I'm going to hit launch. Okay, enter location. I am in Utah. And I'm going to go ahead and select that rating and hit submit. Now I did not add like a little alert button at the end of it. You may want to have like a pop-up or a layer show saying thank you or some text or something like that. But I'm going to go ahead and close that out. It will still send over the statement. If I go to view registration statement, notice that Jeff Batt answered ratings question with a score of 7 at the location Utah. So that's how you can provide additional content in your statements. Now, one kind of word of caution is you probably don't want your initial statement to be really long. You probably want to keep those as close or as simple as possible, like right here, Jeff Batt satisfied sample. But you can provide additional context in the description. So if you wanted to provide additional context and use the variables, you can do that in the description. So hopefully this was helpful for you to be able to see how you can use variables to expand and provide additional content to your learning record store or to your learning management system that supports CMI5 and xAPI. If you want to check out more, go ahead and go back to my website at learningdojo.ninja. You can check out my blog with all different kinds of tips and tricks. You can download templates. You can get full courses, everything from A to Z on Articulate, Storyline 360, Adobe Captivate, xAPI Fundamentals, Articulate Rise, Custom Squirm, and HTML5 Video. Also, if you like this video, go ahead and go to my YouTube channel and hit that like button and subscribe to my channel, and that helps me my channel out tremendously, and so I can keep providing these videos to you as well. And also comment down below, what else do you want to see? What are you struggling with xAPI? What do you want to know? I am happy to provide or add these different types of requests to my backlog and work on these different types of videos for you. But that's all that I have for today. So thanks everyone.